Now this is going to be a femur. The femur, or the main bone of your upper thigh, or for that matter, the only bone of your upper thigh. What we have is a nice round head of the femur, which will articulate with the acetabulum of the coxal bone. This round head going around the femur is above the neck, makes sense. But then as we go more lateral on the bone, so the head's medial, this rough protrusion out here, you can see how it goes all around the bone. This rough protrusion is going to be your greater trochanter. While this smaller protrusion down here, so we turn around, this smaller one is the lesser trochanter. So lesser trochanter, greater trochanter. Now if you flip over to the posterior side of the bone, you can see this ridge of bone running down. That ridge of bone is the linea aspera. The linea aspera. It's always on the posterior side. If we go back to the anterior side, or the front, we're going to notice this smooth patch right here. That smooth patch is where the patella is going to sit. It's where the patella can sit and ride on the knee. The smooth surface for the patellar surface. Then we have our medial and lateral condyles, so we'll turn this over a little bit. This structure right here and here, the distal ends of the bone, well, if you're on the same side as the head, that means that's the medial condyle. This is the lateral condyle. Right in between the two, this indent, is the intercondylar fossa. It's the intercondylar fossa. And then above that, we're going to have on each side the medial, again, same size as the head, medial epicondyle, and opposite side of the head, lateral epicondyle. So medial condyle, medial epicondyle, lateral epicondyle, and intercondylar fossa. So how do we know if this is a right or a left? Well, head has to be medial, and we know the linea aspera must be posterior. That means this is a right femur. A right femur.